Hey man, this is another podcast we're going to do.
Yo!
What's it going to be about today?
Today we're going to be looking at alternative Prime Ministers of the UK.
That's right.
As it is the general election coming very soon.
That's very important.
It is very important, yeah.
If we don't share our thoughts, then you can end up voting for someone you hate.
We're here not to trick your minds, but to give an alternate look on life and the way this country is run and who runs it.
Very philosophical. Yeah.
That's today's topic, isn't it?
Okay.
So should we get started?
Yeah, man. So what the candidates we got at the moment?
Yeah, my first leader I would vote for is Boris Johnson.
Really? Him?
Have you not, or have you seen some of the YouTube videos which emerge from Boris Johnson?
No.
Speaking at various London political debates and everything. And
does he know anything?
No, that's why I would vote for him.
Oh, you see, that's where you fall down.
No.
Can't be a leader.
Have you heard some of the insults he says to people?
No, actually.
Really?
Tell me.
Recognise me. Are you saying they haven't the guts to put questions to me? Great supine protoplasmic invertebrate jellies.
Yeah, I don't think it'd last long, really.
No, of course he wouldn't, but that's why I'd vote for him. It'd be hilarious.
Just have 5 years of turmoil.
Yeah, no, this podcast is alternate leaders.
But he's got a great haircut, so you love that.
And he's absolutely bonkers. He's off his head.
Do you think when he goes home in the evening, he goes to the wardrobe and his haircut hangs Boris Johnson up in the wardrobe and then his hair gets into bed? I think that's what happens.
They don't tell you,
but that's what happens.
They didn't tell you. All the political parties, all fake. That's what really happens behind the scenes. Yeah. So who would you think would make a good prime minister?
My suggestion for a fantasy leader is the one and only Steve Coogan, of course, which I think would be great.
As Steve Coogan or Alan Partridge?
Oh yeah, good question. As Alan Partridge,
yes,
in character,
absolutely.
As Alan, which is hard to maintain for 5 goddamn years.
And possibly 10 if he wins a second term.
Which he probably would, because I mean he would just trump all the other leaders at the moment. He'd probably know more as well, even in character. You could stop giggling or I'll take down your particulars. You know, how could you not love that?
This is great banter. It really is.
Anyway, who's next for you?
Next for me.
Next to me.
I was thinking Eddie Izzard. What do you think?
Eddie Izzard.
He did actually say, back in 2010, he said, in 10 years' time, I'm actually going to run.
He did, no. Was
which
that...
I really hope he does, because he's very intelligent.
Was that part of his comedy sketch he did at one gig?
I don't think so. I think he said it in an interview.
Really?
Which is more serious than a stand-up.
That is very serious.
Stand-up piece.
That is very serious.
It is, yeah. It's very serious. Yeah, very, very serious. Very serious.
Damn. This is just serious.
Yeah, this is very serious, man.
Yeah.
Yeah. I can't stress how serious this is.
Actually, speaking about this, I think we're more on about dictatorships now, aren't we?
Yeah, that's the thing, because actually, on a serious note, we're still very serious, but we're about to get even seriouslier.
Guys, prepare your minds, please. Sit down.
We live in a capitalist democracy at the moment, and capitalism isn't actually the best way of living in a country. Take, for example, CEOs of large retail companies like... W.H. Smith, for example, I used to work there. The CEO of that, I know his name, Steve Clark. I don't like him because he's.
You don't
probably,
like him.
I don't like. I hate his guts. If he came into my shop when I worked there, I would have actually spat on him. And the reason being is because no, I would have done. And I hope it was filmed as well, because that would be great. You know, CEO visits store, gets spat on as a headline.
I'd love that. I can see that right now. Yeah.
But the reason why I do that is because he's on a salary of probably $300,000 plus a year, and he pays all his employees in stores. Minimum wage to the penny.
Yeah.
And that is the ultimate middle finger to all your employees.
Oh, yeah.
And that is a fine example of capitalism. Well, there we have it. We started this out with a kind of a premise of fantasy leaders.
Mm-hmm.
And we're both actually, turns out, I didn't know this. You didn't know this. We're really passionate.
No, we are. Absolutely.
And you should be as well. So vote.
For yourself.
Vote for yourself. That's the one.
Everyone needs to have self-confidence in this business.
Vote for happiness.
Vote. You know what? Vote for love.
Vote for cake.
Vote for food, and just vote for your soul.
Vote for Megatron.
Vote for Megatron.
As leader of the universe.
Wow.
I'm going to leave you with a song that'll to play us out, and then after that we've got We've got loads of great performers coming in for a bit.
Yeah, yeah.
To see, yeah, we've got Susan's Breakfast. They're going to come in and play for us.
Really?
Yeah.
Oh, I love Susan's Breakfast.
We've got Tripod.
Tripod?
Yeah. This is my song. This one's called... And hope you enjoy it.